It is harvest time at the Cimarron Research Station. Joining us is Becky Carroll, Extension Assistant in Fruit and Nut Crops. We could hear a lot of activity here at the research station.
We have some propane cannons going off, and then there's a bird guard. It's kind of a scare sound to keep the crows and other critters away. So,
because this is the time of year when the shucks are opening,
yep.
A lot of the birds will come in and try to steal our harvest.
Right, and one crow or one squirrel, they can take about a pound of nuts per day. Mm-hmm. So if you consider the expense of a pound of pecans, that's pretty expensive if you let them get too much. And they can take your entire crop if you're not careful. So the sooner we can get them off the tree and into our building, into our house, the better off we have of having a good crop that year.
So I want to look at what homeowners need to do to harvest their crop. And I think the first step is, when do we need to start harvesting?
Right. Pecans ripen, they start in October. And depending on the varieties, it can be into November or even into December whenever they ripen. So you need to pick a variety that's going to be suitable for your area. Mm-hmm. So if it's still closed and we get a hard freeze, they may not open.
Okay.
So we want to make sure that we have an early ripening fruit in the northern parts of the state. Mm-hmm. The southern areas can be a little bit later, but we want to have something that's going to open early so they don't get frozen in the shuck. But anytime these sutures on the shuck start to split, that means the pecan is ripe and ready to be harvested. So whenever you first see these little sutures starting to split open, you can get out there and start getting them out of the tree and harvesting, because they'll just pull right out of there. You can see where that little tissue has been holding the nut in place, and now it's no longer getting anything from that tree anymore. So it's ripe and ready to be harvested.
Okay.
So,
and so obviously we can wait for them to fall to the ground, but that gives a lot of opportunity for other critters to gather up.
A lot of people have to depend on the wind to knock them out of the trees. And in Oklahoma, that's not a problem a lot of the time, but the sooner we can get them inside, the better chance we have having a good crop, because the crows, blue jays, squirrels, turkeys, deer, everything else likes pecans too. So
And so you have a really simple tool to whack those seeds down, and I'm going to step back and let you demonstrate.
This is a frailing pole, and you can see up in the tree we have most of these shucks are open, so I'm going to get in here and just try to knock them down. And we've put a tarp on the ground to see if we can get them to land where we want them to. It's not going to happen for all of them, but if we can get some of them out on the tarp, that would be helpful.
Well, Becky, you've dropped quite a few pecans down here, and I could see some of them are still in their husks. And my guess, this one's not really open. Is there a problem with this?
This one may have some type of insect damage or other damage. It may just be not a quality pecan.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a few other ones that I found. I think this one had early insect damage and it's not going to open. But a lot of the time, any type of disease or insect damage on the shuck is going to prevent them from opening at the proper time. So if you have something like this, you can try to open them. Like this one was, you can just pull them out if they're loose. But like this one, it's tight and it's not going to open, so it's probably not good.
We'll just discard those.
And the thing about pecans, all of this liquid in the shuck, the more you touch it, the more it stains your fingers.
Okay.
So you can tell pecan people because they have brown fingers at this time of year.
And that's just full of moisture, and that's the reason we don't want to leave this in here to dry. We want to go ahead and pull those out of
there. Yeah, we want to exclude any of these. They're called stick tights.
Okay.
And we want to take them out of our bucket as we're picking up, because they'll just be moisture to add to mold possibilities later.
Okay. So speaking of picking up, we dropped a large amount onto the tarp to make it easy to pick those up, but you have tools also. There's a variety of different tools for collecting pecans if they just fall in the yard, right?
Yep, we've got this little picker-upper. I'm not sure what its name is, but it just has the wire bottom, and you go along and just pick up individual nuts. A lot easier on the tarp. They're right there available, but it works in the grass too. You can see it works over here just fine. And then whenever you get your little basket full, you just empty it into a 5-gallon bucket or whatever you're using and keep going.
Okay.
And that saves your knees, and you're not having to be bending or on your hands
right.
and knees picking up nuts all afternoon.
And there's several different types of these small rollers. Mm-hmm. There's a couple that look like a slinky on
right?
a stick.
And you just roll them along. It looks kind of like a toy. Maybe you can get some kids to help you out with that if they think it looks fun. So
and
we've
you have
got
a bigger
version. Mm-hmm. This is it's called a bag-a-nut. And so it rolls along. It has little fingers, and it acts kind of like the commercial type of harvester, but it uses those little fingers to pick them up and then empty them into the basket. Mm-hmm. And then whenever you get ready to, you could maybe go to your tarp or somewhere, and then it just dumps out and empties, and then you can pick them up in one area.
Mm-hmm. And before you use something like this, you can actually use a leaf blower and clear the leaves out of the
right.
way so we don't get as much debris
right.
as we just
Or
did.
You could use just a regular rake and rake them together, and then that way you don't have to go quite as, you know, around as much. It'll just be in one localized area.
All right, once we've picked up all our nuts, we need to dry them
yeah.
so that we can store them later. So for drying, we need really good air circulation.
Right. At this point, when they come off the tree, they have a really high moisture content. Especially if we're knocking them out of the tree, they may have 15 or 20% moisture, so they can be kind of rubbery. Mm-hmm. And we want to dry them down to about 4 or 5% moisture. And the good way to know when you're at that level is you take a kernel and you just break it in half and it snaps.
Mm-hmm.
And so you can actually hear the snap of the kernel.
Mm-hmm.
And so that tells you that it's at a good moisture level. This one needs just a little bit more drying and it'll be good. Some of these others that were taken out of the shuck, they're quite a bit wetter, and they just feel kind of rubbery at this point.
Mm-hmm. Okay,
so.
And we want to make sure that we get those dried. Is that about a 1 to 2 week process?
It depends on your moisture of the air outside. Mm-hmm. If it's raining or high humidity, it may take a little bit longer, but usually a week if you had a fan on them or hanging up somewhere, that's going to dry them out pretty well.
And once they're dry, we could store them in the freezer.
Yeah, you can get them cracked or you can store them in shell, either way. If you left them out at room temperature, they'll only be good for about maybe 3 to 6 months.
Mm-hmm.
In shell, they'll last a little bit longer, maybe 6 months. If they're shelled already, it may be 3 months, and they'll start to go rancid because of the high oil content. But if we store them in the refrigerator, they'll last a little bit longer. But if we store them in the deep freeze, they'll last for maybe 5, 6, 7, 8 years. So
excellent. Yeah. All right.
So.
Well, thank you so much for
sure.
showing us.
You're welcome.